Good afternoon, it's Tony Hayes from Parliament of Education UK. Today's date is the 21st of January 2022, and today we're looking at movie 340. This came about over the last really YouTube movie I did concerning how to analyse RDO and dust. And when I first viewed the movie, which came in from a CCTV system, an alert, I thought it was just dealing with dust, insects and some noises outside and how they can contaminate a recording. While I was doing that, getting towards the end of the footage, around about 50 seconds, I suddenly realised, because this CCTV footage came in from the main office area at the Chester case, an unusual sound, so I stopped the video at that point, uploaded the movie on to analyse audio and light anomalies, and thought, well, I'll need to come back and look at this sound in a little bit more detail. So that's the position we're at today. So I'm going to really, so I'm really setting off from where I left it yesterday, and I'm just going to play this through. It's that sound there. I'm going to turn it up. It's there. Let's take it back a bit further. So it's clearly closer to the camera. It sounds like it's within the room itself. I've got some bass frequency that's pumping up because I'm pretty confident you can't hear that on normal volume. Pull that down to real time. You see it jump in there. And obviously, as I begin to amplify, I'm lifting this bass volume up, so I can take that out. That's no major problem. That so it just cleans it up a little bit. Always be careful about removing frequency, as long as you don't affect the one that you're interested in. So I'm going to go back to average again. So it's a spike of frequency. There's a little reflection there, about 600 hertz, but predominantly 700 to 800. It's quite a tight. This is quite unusual. Sometimes when we've been dealing with some of the wraps in this building, that would be shifted to the right between 800 and 1,000 hertz. There are various graphs you can download on the internet. As an example, I was once given a piece of footage where the client was suggesting that it was a woman screaming. And when you heard it, it certainly was a woman screaming. But when I looked at the frequency, it's around about 3,500 hertz, which is miles away from human frequency. And when I then went looking for samples, I realised it was an urban fox. And when I played them side by side, that's what that scream was. It wasn't a woman's voice, it was an urban fox. So what you can do, you can always go on the internet and put 700 to 800 hertz, and it may say that's quite interesting. Because the other day, this is a job as an investigator, to investigate whether the source is, even if it does have a rational or natural explanation. So what it's saying, it's a UHF range, ultra high frequency, and within the radial bands. So considering that the the cameras are in fact Wi-Fi, would that mean that it is some sort of radio, an issue with the camera, because it's been recorded by the camera and the camera works on Wi-Fi, right, okay, that's quite interesting. So that could in fact be just something to do with the camera. I've not seen this one before. It certainly never happened before. It's getting towards of the it's around about 50 seconds, getting towards the end of the footage. And when you, what you often find with it, I'm just going to save that. I'll show you what I mean. Shut that down. I'm just going to bring some footage, and I'll show you exactly what it is that you need to be aware of when you're analysing CCTV camera footage. Now, the way these cameras work, you have to do numerous tasks. One is to film the footage. Two, the audio. It has to send it through Wi-Fi, and at the same time record it onto the drive or onto the hard, a separate hard drive if it's connected on, onto a Wi-Fi network. The audio itself often lags behind by about a second and a half. And I'll show you what I mean. Get towards the end of this. Actually, this one's okay. This camera's okay. Sometimes what you actually see is that, sorry, wrong way round, is that you often see that the audio is lagging behind. This one, actually, in fairness, now we've double checked, is exactly the same. So obviously, the cameras have been changed over the years. You do have a limited shelf life, and I know this camera in the main office has been changed on at least one occasion, and obviously it's upgraded. The firmware or the hardware, the cameras have improved to the point where latency isn't a problem. Certainly on some of the earlier piece of footage, I haven't got a hard drive in, so I can't show you that. Whoops, wrong one. So latency issues where the camera's under quite a lot of strain, that's what causes latency. It's running out of memory to keep the audio and the visual footage to be cinched together. Isn't a problem with that particular camera, but we have got this sound that's obviously in the middle of it, which is there. Just close the band down a little bit. Okay. That's better. It's just not loud enough to, yeah, it's just got it there now. Just a simple snippet. on low volume. Whenever it is that you're taking screenshots of some sort of analysis that you're completing, the less you do as far as enhancements concerns, the better. So I'm going to take all the EQ off. There's no volume added whatsoever, so I'm not amplified it. And just that little snippet of frequency there on normal volumes. And that's the one that I'm going to take the use a sniping tool and take a screenshot of. So it has got the potential as the Google, you know, it's a great service to us, Google, suggesting it's some sort of antenna frequency, may well be connected with that one, but we've got a record of it, which means if it occurs again at some other point in time, we can then got something almost like a baseline to reflect back on. So, it's just a quick video today. I wanted just to cover that because as the case is progressing, Chester, I don't want to leave any stone unturned, really, even though this looks practically not a piece of evidence as such. It is, because if it happens again, and if it is that the camera is getting worn and producing sounds or, you know, noises that we don't want, then the camera will need to be changed once again. So, okay, hope that was useful. See you on the next movie.